So we never really updated from last night, but it was a super cool experience last night. I actually met my online friend, like online best friend. It's kind of like coming out of nowhere, we know, but point is, I just started to record because like we woke up in our hotel room and then, well, what the fuck? I'll just, this shit hard start happening. Pretty random, dude. All right, I'm about to head out for some breakfast. We're vloggers now, by the way. Well, I mean, this is like our first kind of video like this, so we're like trying to figure it out. But so anyways, like, yeah, so
are you at the hotel or are you at home?
Anyways,
damn, it's a nice
bro. Damn, this car looks good in the like filter. All right, we're gonna eat
take a video of the menu,
whatever this is. What is this place?
It's called, se llama Tortas Belén. Whoa. This place has been here for the last bits of my childhood.
Damn. Damn. Okay, got a lot to live up to with that name, though. Mierda.
They don't have drinks here, so we might need to go.
Oh, that's smart. That
they're right next to a gas station.
All right, bro, let's do it.
Bro, Tortas Belén, that place is so fire, bro. Kelvin's not here to testify, bro. We all down that place, bro. We ate everything and we didn't film it. I don't know why, we just didn't film, so that's why I'm like filling in the blanks. But dude, it was good. We didn't sit there to eat, we took it to the house, and bro, dude, that shit was good. And then after we ate that, dude, we just chilled in the house. We had like 2 hours to spare, bro. I literally knocked out. Kelvin knocked out. Jeff was just like watching TikToks or whatever. And then while I was chilling, I was like, we filmed a TikTok. Like, we were so bored, like waiting, but tired. So we were kind of like funny tired.
All right, bro. Good night.
Good night.
All right. Oh, shoot. I forgot to get my water.
After we waited a bit, we got to the event. And the event was so cool.
Finally made it.
Yes, sir.
Nice.
Here
you
go. Oh, time to sign my life away. Hang on 1 second.
How are you doing?
You got to get him signed.
Oh, yeah.
I know. It's holding up for right now. That's where we're worried about the clouds.
This fool. Yeah. What do you think?
Fingers crossed, man.
Yeah. Nah, we're ready for it. Are you ready for it?
Mm-hmm.
How you feeling? Good to talk.
Seeing Zach Triggs' car for the first time. We saw there was a car there that was on the Burnyard in Hoonigan. We covered all of this. And again, like, we literally tried to cover as much as we can. So we finally made it here. That's pretty cool. Yeah, finally made it here. Everything's looking pretty good. The weather's looking a little rough, but it should be all good. So let's get some footage and shit.
Let's see what we got going on out here.
Just getting signed in. A lot of stuff going on here. Kelvin's kind of talking to Jimmy right now, who's in charge of all the media things and where we're gonna be on track.
See?
Yeah, we're just gonna follow along and then. Yeah, exactly. We only have one media pass left, which means that only one person can be on track at a time. So we'll probably just go ahead and just switch it out continuously to use the different cameras and everything. But we're gonna go into the pro shop right now, so I will update y'all later.
Your area. There's a gentleman, his name's Chris Beanbone. He has an Astros hat, big guy. His vest, I think he has an orange vest that says security. He's like our senior photographer here. Oh, so he's like the,
I think I've seen his videos already.
Yeah, yeah, he does. He's been doing a lot of our stuff for a long time. So he's like our manager, media manager out there. So he'll tell you if you're in a not a good spot or whatever, but you can see all the media people are vibing and whatnot hanging out. So okay.
sobriety. So we're currently here, Knuckle Up, Texas. Has been an awesome day so far. I got a 40-minute interview with Zach Triggs and NSSC. And I'm just currently just getting videos. I started to take videos right now. And then I'm also taking some, mostly pictures, but I'm going to switch to video right now because I know Kelvin and Erica and Bruno and all of them have already worked on getting pictures. So I'm going to just focus on video. All right, so Zach Triggs has a GoPro, one of our GoPros in it, facing him. I hope it looks super good. I hope it looks super, super good. If he wins this, then it's gonna be facing the other side, but basically done for the day. It's just kind of like free track right now, free like open track. I guess I could get some footage, but we're kind of tired. Zach Triggs was a super cool dude.
She was fucking awesome, man.
So we're probably gonna edit all this footage and then try to get home tomorrow around 9. Should be easier than what happened us trying to get here. But anyways, yeah, it was an awesome event. It was an awesome turnout. Great way to kick off like one of our first YouTube videos. But yeah, we're probably just gonna chillax here and then we're gonna go downtown today. I don't know if I might bring the camera or not. We'll see. Like if I decide to bring it, then we'll have some content from there too. I'll probably just do it for my phone. But yeah, we'll catch you guys. Whatever we do next after this. I don't really like filming too much in moments like these. I just like to really take it in because it's been an awesome fucking weekend, not gonna lie. But alrighty.
Alright, so this is like what, day 3 of editing? As life has to go on, we are in kind of relocated into a different spot. I have to work on my car and get this piece of shit back up on the road. And yeah, so that's kind of the change of scenery. So after Knuckle Up, that was crazy because we have one more day in Houston, but we literally try to pack one day's worth of travels or 2 days worth of travel into one night. And from there, from Knuckle Up, you know, we changed our home and then headed out after that point to go to downtown Houston. That drive was fucking sick.
Now, bro.
Right now,
what? Oh, shit, boy.
So we get past
Let him do his thing. Let him bait.
Let him be the local.
Let him be the bait. Let him be the local.
We come up on the right, fucking SRT Trackhawk on the right hand side.
Oh, look at the nigga coming to the right.
Oh, shit.
Why he going for him, bro? They going for it.
I gotta see this. We're fucking Houston right now, man. We're fucking Houston. They're racing on the belt like it was fucking nothing, like.
1320 Houston with the quiet And that dude just took over from there. I was like, you know what? I don't got enough horsepower to hang, but y'all can have fun, and I'm just gonna watch.
Fucking conjoying on the fucking, Houston's, mate. Holy man, shit, man.
You know what I'm saying?
They done doing it, mate. Holy
catalog,
fuck.
Million a month. You know what I mean? Oh, look, we gon' pull that shit out on a Sunday. Racing with the click up the one way. Today I'ma tear up these tires. Doing donuts in an intersection slide. We gon' pull that shit out on a Sunday. Racing with the click up the one way. Today I'ma tear up these tires. Doing donuts in an intersection slide. LA summer. I'm in a blue Chevrolet. Snap top, super hot, new C8. That's all I need in this world of sin. Sunday night riding out with the click. Beat hitting hard on 10. Dupree got a girl coming through. Tell her bring friends. We pulling up in Benz like twins.
Damn, bro, y'all really got it like that here, huh?
We do.
It's funny, bro. We were at Knuckle Up, bro. There was like these people that were playing music, right? And then out of nowhere, I heard like these people say, "Fuck New York, that nasty ass state."
Yeah.
That shit was so funny, man. Oh my God, what is that? Is that Celica?
No, it's a crossfire.
Oh, crossfire. Damn, we really squatted up right now, but. Oh my God, dude.
I keep forgetting how to move.
That's Zach. Oh, look at that. That looks so nice.
This is where the view starts.
Damn, bro. Look at Houston, bro. H-Town.
What the fuck? Wait till you see it from the street. Can you just put those on the ceiling?
spot called the Rice Box, which it's like this super cool cyberpunk futuristic place over in downtown Houston. I didn't even know it was in downtown Houston. I've always knew. I knew it was in Texas, but I never knew it was in downtown Houston.
Holy shit, man. This place is nice.
Oh, look where we're coming up on.
Oh, shit, we're right here. This is nice.
We're at the internet, too.
This place is really nice. This is the legendary place. This shit looks so cool. Oh my god. Bro, this restaurant, whatever the hell this is, it's a restaurant, right?
It's a restaurant.
Yeah, it's giving the illest, like, cyberpunk vibes, bro. It is awesome.
Now, Rice Box was super cool. Just like the ambience, the lighting, just the whole design of that restaurant was absolutely awesome, bro. Like I really enjoyed that place. A lot of the content from there is gonna be on our Instagram, since it's mainly pictures. It's gonna be on our Instagram and website, but it's mainly pictures and reels that we took, so all that is gonna be on Instagram. You know, really, for content wise for like the main trip video, it was pretty uneventful, just because we really went there, ate, took some pictures of the Lexus, took some pictures of the area, recorded some reels, and really all went on our Instagram, so. Probably one of the coolest, if not my favorite part of the whole trip, happened right after this. Going to downtown, like right after this, we went ahead and just decided to explore downtown, see what it has to offer. It was really surreal being there for some reason. It just felt like super like dreamy, just cause like, it's a city that's not too big, but not too small. You know, you were able to walk around, see what it had to offer. Like, I don't know. For some reason, seeing the city just felt really surreal and like ethereal for some reason.
Bro, this is like the Kanjo Tokyo Loop, C1 Loop in Japan, bro.
Nice.
Damn, this is so nice. And the camera will never do it justice.
Like, you have to see those eyes.
Never, dude. And you need eyes to look at that, bro.
That is insane.
Is there like a parkway that goes around the city? Like this?
The one we're on 610. Right now?
Oh, 610. Is that like the smaller loop?
There, yeah. Like, that's the smallest loop, but you'll only get to see it from the corner. You don't ever get to see it right, like this close.
Please keep it smooth, bro.
I'm just
gonna. Hi,
Rob.
Is that like?
Well, usually the homeless people don't do anything, but sometimes, like, I don't know what they got going on.
In 1,000 feet.
Yeah.
And they get aggressive because they think you're gonna steal their spot.
Yeah.
And they try to shank you with like a broken bottle, and you're like, nah, I'm just trying. You're gonna see his face.
Whoa.
Whoa.
Roshi-san with the Lamborghini.
Yeah, that is
literally like, that's Roshi what it reminds me of. Yeah.
That is so cool. Whoa.
He knows you're taking a video of Susan.
Nah,
that dude's sparking. That dude's sparking.
Fuck.
Yeah, I'm coming, you fucking menace. Look, now he's leaving, bro.
Now he's leaving, bro.
He's gonna fuck us up. Bro, now none of us got that parking spot, bro. God damn.
Whoa, why is there so much people in there?
Oh, anime material.
Oh, it's anime material. It's still going on?
Yeah. Yeah, because of anime material, I don't think we're going to find parking.
Oh my god, that's Anime Missouri. Dude, I wanna go.
Yo, love your truck.
Throw a sticker at him.
Okay, I'm glad.
I was just looking out for scooters. Them niggas don't care. Them niggas hashtag ain't care.
What the fuck going on in Miami, bro? We should have just taken that girl's spot.
Bro, we should just.
There was a cop behind me, though. That's why. No, behind me when the girl, like, when I was taking the girl's spot. Yeah, and that's why I tell you, he like pulls up like mad looking, like trying to look at us like, you good, bro?
Whoa! Isn't that a spot right in front of that Central? Yeah. No, this is not even risky. Do your thing, girl. Do your thing.
You like my mom.
I would not attempt this. Yeah, that's what I'm saying, right? It's like, god damn. Nah, bro, you are.
What? You're barely under the line.
You're barely under the line, though.
Yeah, I'm like actually over the line. Like, not over the line. I'm like in the line, so we're good.
Let's go.
Alright, what the fuck, bro? This place is fucking sick.
There's so much to do outside of Orlando. Like, we don't even have shit like this in
our
lab.
No, that one's fire. Dude, because seeing that labyrinth, kind of like in the middle of the city-ish, kind of. It was like surrounded by buildings, though. Seeing all the cool little like bricks and everything everyone made, that was pretty cool. And it was just all quiet there. Like, it was just walking through that thing, just seeing all these different like pieces of art that are just bricks. And then we got to the middle. Jeff started pointing at the buildings and showing us like cool different things about them. Yeah, that was a pretty cool part of the night.
Let me be actually a good citizen and actually like fix this. That's how we do it, my boy.
That's how you change the world.
I really like this one. Now this is the one. Now this is the one.
I'm not sure which.
That's gotta be behind this one. They got a movie theater.
Damn, they got a movie theater on the roof? It's gotta be that one.
No.
The way is that one.
So you're taking a girl to this one.
This one?
Yeah.
This park?
Yeah.
Wait till you see the other place.
Alright, that's true. Oh, there's another place. Alright, I thought this was this one or the other one.
That's where you wanted to end the night, right?
That's where I want to end the night.
Oh, I know where it is. And I know where it is. I know exactly what it is, and I know that it's that one. It's the one that's like by the river.
We just passed like leaving right
now. That has like the parkways going over it.
Whenever you guys are ready to go back.
Alright, let's do it.
We went to this park and right on the other side of it, the convention center was there. Now we were aware that there was some event going on there, Anime Matsuri. So it's kind of like this giant anime convention essentially, much like Comic Con and everything like that.
What did we just walk into?
Yeah. This is Anime Matsuri.
Damn, bro, it stinks
already. It smells like popcorn.
Straight up.
Picture me at the sign.
Bro, that was such a tourist, bro.
Shut up.
Random. They got Liddy in there, bro. What? Bro, that looks like fun.
And we're like, we saw a ton of people just coming from one area, so we just kept walking down the convention hall, and we see just this massive party, like just a massive like concert party, whatever going on in there. And we were like, dude, we gotta get in there.
So we're trying to sneak into an anime party. I don't know if Jeff secured the bag. I guess let's see what happens.
While brainstorming trying to get in, some dude just came up to us, saying, offering us tickets to get in for $10, and we're like, yo, this is pretty sus. Like, are these even real? And so well, we've tried a couple things already at this point. Bruno, he just whipped out a 10 and gave it to him, and I was like, what, dude, are you serious? And then he walked right in, and when he got in, he found a wristband on the floor and somehow found a paperclip. And so he grabbed the wristband, came out with the paperclip, and told me put it on. And then he had me put the paperclip to clip the wristband in, and we walked in. I didn't film us actually walking in,
so I guess we snuck in then.
Oh, baby, make some noise.
But yeah, I mean, after that, we kind of just wrapped it up. Went to this one more spot that Jeff wanted to show us, aka Bruno, that he wanted to show us, which was pretty sick. It was pretty cool seeing that spot.
So Jeff just took us to a really cool place.
And a bunch at Lil Uzi Vert 21 Savage. That was, I'm telling you, the main stage was over here, but they closed that street. So you would be over there.
How the parking lot?
Pretty surreal.
And like a cool way to just end like our full day here. Looks fucking sick. Damn.
Man, that E6 is so fire.
The water was up.